Imagine Dragons, Radioactive. Thanks, Ollie, for that video. It looked like he died at the end.
It looked like he died at the end. I don't really understand
how. He kind of touched some mysterious water and then fell on the floor.
Maybe he just tripped.
Maybe it was radioactive water.
You know, the chances of that being intentional are quite high.
I think so.
BBC Radio 1.
So at Radio 1's big weekend last weekend in Glasgow, during one of the many, many periods where I was just walking around pretending to be on the phone to people, I was approached by some friends with cameras, which is always a very bad sign, and they said that they were making a montage video of people singing Clean Bandit, okay? It was
okay.
Some big Radio 1 big weekend project, and I thought, oh, another lip sync thing, super cringe. You know, I've done these before, and you know, I don't like lip syncing, it's a bit embarrassing. But then they were like, please, Dad. And I was like, okay, I guess they're my friends. And then they went, Liam Payne did it, so you have to do it. And I was like, oh, if Liam from One Direction's done it, I have to do it too. So they set up this camera, and I'm holding this jukebox, and I start miming along to Clean Bandit with all these people looking at me. And then they're all just like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Like, what was wrong? And they're like, no, it's karaoke.
Oh.
It's not lip syncing. And I was like, what?
That's a whole new ballgame.
I just signed my, like, lip syncing. Okay, that's fine. But karaoke. So I was just like on the spot then. There is nothing worse than someone trying to sing and it being terrible. So when I was just on the spot, I went down the route of being deliberately crap.
Oh, I see.
You know what I mean? So I was like, okay, I'm deliberately singing really bad. It was quite traumatizing. And even though it's been on the YouTube channel, I haven't watched it yet because I'm too scared.
Well, I have seen it. And I think it's amazing. And also, though it's obvious you were being deliberately bad, you still sounded kind of good.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Oh, great.
You could have a future pop career. So get to bbc.co.uk/radio1 now to watch it with me and Dan. And also, it features One Direction, The Vamps, Grimmy, Scott, Yumi at Six, and of course Dan. Here is Clean Bandit with Rather Be.
Big weekend karaoke edition.
BBC Radio 1.
I like that little Glasgow at the end there. That was okay. I coped.
That was really good.
That was it was quite funny to listen to. It puts into perspective how terrible everyone else was at the end.
I like Matt Edmondson's singing voice. It's just his normal voice.
Where did he get that hat as well? It's a bit of Alan Partridge, wasn't it, to be honest?
I feel like it was missing a certain someone in the form of me.
Was it? Oh, yeah. I'm sure that you would have improved it so much.
I've got a really deep singing voice, so I'd just be like, no place I'd rather be. Do you see the graveliness of that?
Yeah, Phil, really gravelly.
Simon Cowell.
Sexual. I'm sure everyone would love that. Well, if you want to see the faces that went along with that awful but quite lovely and inspirational singing, then you can check out the video on the Radio 1 YouTube channel. Just search for Big Weekend Karaoke. Do you reckon it was worth it for me to be nice to my friends and
Definitely.
Say yeah? I mean, being nice, okay, people like you, but it's very traumatizing. I think it's just better to be a diva.
I liked your Illuminati triangle as well.
That's what I was going for.
How suspicious. Anyway, I'm looking at my screen with all the text on it, and
okay.
I can see Kate, Sinead, and Rich and Laura are on a road trip back home from Bristol, and they really want to hear All Saints with Never Ever.
Oh my God.
Which is going to change everyone's life again. So here it is now.
Channel, just search for Big Weekend Karaoke. Do you reckon it was worth it for me to be nice to my friends and
Definitely.
Say yeah? I mean, being nice, okay, people like you, but it's very traumatizing. I think it's just better to be a diva.
I liked your Illuminati triangle as well.
That's what I was going for.
How suspicious. Anyway, I'm looking at my screen with all the text on it, and
okay.
I can see Kate, Sinead, and Rich and Laura are on a road trip back home from Bristol, and they really want to hear All Saints with Never Ever.
Oh my God.
Which is going to change everyone's life again. So here it is now.